guys, welcome back to Iron Gryphon Studio. I hope you're all well. My name is Alan, and this week I've been creating two interesting pieces of terrain. The wall fountain, the Viking fire pit thing. So yeah, if you do like this video, don't forget to leave a like and a comment and a subscribe and ring the little bell and things. And if you want to check out my Patreon, that's there too as well. I'll see you all on the other side. Alright, so for the Viking style fire pit, we're going to need a little bit of XPS foam. There's some 4-inch lengths here. These are going to act as some walls. The adjacent walls are going to be 1.5 inches long, and they're about 1 centimeter deep. And the main base of it is going to be a 3x5 inch section, and it's going to be outfitted just like dungeon tiles with these slabs on the other side there. So I'm going to cut into the lines that I've drawn on here, just about 1 millimeter or so, just to etch out the pavement slabs, and then I'll deepen these with a beveling tool of sorts. You can use a cocktail stick or something, but I usually use a sharpened paintbrush handle. And you might even notice I'm not going all the way along the middle of it, because most of the middle is going to be concealed by the fire trough, or the fire pit that goes on top of it. And this should help preserve its strength a little bit, because it is only a very thin piece of foam. It's probably only about 5 millimeters thick. The idea of this is so that it can sit on top of existing dungeon tiles, or you could set it in between dungeon tiles and set it kind of into the floor, so that it creates a bit of a texture there to the groundwork. And because on a few occasions this thing is going to be set on top of dungeon tiles, I'm going to need to texture the edge, so I'm going to continue this slab theme all the way around the edge. And notice I'm being very careful there to brace the foam with my thumb, just to add a bit of stability to this, because otherwise it's quite easy to snap the foam in half. And for texture on stonework, I'm going to use the go-to method of the aluminium ball. This is kind of everyone's favorite technique, I think. You can use other things, like a rock is perfectly good, as long as it's got some texture to it and roughness. You don't want to have a smooth rock, it's pointless. So just texture the whole thing. Again, I'm only going to go around the edges because the middle won't be seen. And obviously not forgetting to texture the edges as well, and using my fingers and thumb there to really brace the foam as much as possible. It'll also be a lot easier to texture the side pieces as well, so I might as well do those now. And it's time to glue those down using a bit of hot glue. You can use the lines on the base there, where the slabs are, to really gauge where these pieces need to go. I decided to have the long sides of this fire pit overrun the edges a little bit, just to add a little bit of extra detail and texture. And I've cut out a whole bunch of these foam slabs. These are just very tiny ones, and I'm going to texture these in the tumbling box with a few rocks there. And this is a great way to texture lots of little pieces of brickwork very, very quickly. And a quick clean up. And now we can start applying these to the walls. We've got starting to take a bit of shape now, got a bit of structure to it, but the inside of this is starting to look a little bit deep, and I wanted to fill this with kind of coals, but not that much, so I'm going to put a piece of foam in the bottom of this and just hot glue gun it down to add a bit of depth to the middle. Should also strengthen it a little bit too. Adding a little bit of texture to the inside of this. Just going to use a little bit of acrylic paste, get that over everything, hopefully fill in the cracks around the edges where that foam insert meets the walls. So I took my box of ballast and coarse grit and started sprinkling that into the acrylic paste. Quite thick as well. I wanted to have this thing almost entirely full to simulate a big pit full of coals and hopefully provide a good texture for the painting stage. I also grabbed a few bits of wood and I sprinkled them into the trough there, the fire pit, and started to seal them down with a little bit of scenic cement. You can just use regular scenic cement or you could use PVA watered down, that'd be perfectly good. Once that was all set, just give it the foam a quick undercoat in Mod Podge and black paint, and then I sprayed the inside area with just a regular spray primer. And there you can see the inside's all being sprayed as well. I'm just going to add the grey over brush across the whole thing. And then added a few warmer patches of colour to simulate a bit of variation in the rock. Then I took a very vibrant kind of yellow orange paint, watered it down immensely, and then kind of stippled it into all of the texture so that it would run in almost like a wash and tint the underneath of the coals. It dried a little bit less vibrant, but that's okay, and I've added the wash on all the stonework as well, and I've added a few flames in the middle here with a hot glue gun, just kind of pulling away the glue gun as the glue dries so that it would create these little spikes, these little spires of glue, and they're all going to get a little undercoat of a white, and then they're going to get a urial yellow base coat, and then a little bit of orange on top of that just to give it a nice flame effect. I'm going to leave the wood on the inside there mostly black just because it's a better simulation for burnt and charred wood. Alright, moving on to the wall fountain. I'm going to use three pieces of XPS foam here. It's going to be built up in layers. The left hand piece here is going to be the backing so it gets a little brick wall effect added to that. And the other two pieces have their archways cut out and then stuck down with some hot glue. So do the smaller archway first, followed by the larger archway, which actually snapped on the right hand side there, but nothing a bit of hot glue can't fix. Okay, so this little groove here on the side is actually caused by a dowel which I pressed into the side. I'm just going to show you again here on the right, and I can press it in just with my thumbs, creating a nice indent. And I generally use these 5mm wooden dowels to give the impression of small columns or thin posts and pillars on various projects. I added a small bit of foam here at an appropriate height to simulate the bottom of the fountain, and then another piece of foam on the front to act as like a front wall and to keep the water in as well. And then glued in the dowels, which actually had to be shortened because of that wall on the front, which I didn't account for. Now this wall fountain was looking a little bit square at the moment, so I thought I would just cut off those pieces using the archway that was drawn on the back. This is going to be the overall shape of the wall fountain. And then I started on etching in the stonework, so just a few little brick lines in the rock, using an X-Acto blade and then beveled out with this little beveling tool I use here. You can use a cocktail stick or whatever you have. And then I just eyeballed this line through here. A few little bricks on the front. Some texture using the aluminium ball, not too much. I'm going quite light with this one, but in hindsight probably would have been better to texture all of these pieces ahead of time rather than trying to squeeze this aluminium ball into that cap. Never mind. Yep, you guessed it, a bit more Mod Podge and black paint for the undercoat to protect that foam. And I found a few plastic pieces from my bits box to add as decorations on top of these posts. And I found a few charms in my charms box, and this one is an anchor. I just thought I would add that as a bit of extra detail to the stonework, like it had been carved in there. And added two very tiny beads to simulate water spouts. Then once they'd all been undercoated as well, I covered the whole thing in a medium grey. You'll also notice I tidied up the very outside edge of the foam there with a bit of foam cladding just to give it a bit of a nicer finish. And then I added the usual black-brown wash. And then I watered down some green paint. Just wanted to simulate where the water level would be and where maybe a little bit of algae or plant life might start to grow. I then glued in to the water spouts some very thin pieces of hot glue. These are just waste pieces that I thought might be good as a water stream. And then I glued those down to the inside, added some moss on the outside. A lot of moss on the outside, actually. I wanted this thing to be kind of damp and wet all the time, so I thought maybe a lot of moss on the outside would look really good. Okay, time for some water effects. I had to prop this little thing up against some pieces of foam there. I just drizzled it in using a spatula or a coffee stirrer, and hopefully that was enough to let the water effects run into the gap. Apologies that the cup gets in the way on this shot, but I can assure you it's pouring perfectly. And then stand it upright to allow the water effects to settle. Once it has done, I just added a little bit of gloss mod podge to the surface to simulate a few ripples so that the surface wasn't perfectly still. After all, this is all moving water. And I used a straw to blow the ripples into it. And I used a little bit of Liquitex natural sand, which dries clear and it helps to kind of rough up the surface of the water a little bit and add some bubbles. There we go, guys, all finished. I'm pretty happy with the way they both turned out. I used a new product on the fountain here, on the inside, just where the water's a little bit rougher. It's a natural sand product, and it's pretty useful for creating these kind of white water kind of areas where water's moving around a little bit. It does dry clear, so you might have to pick up the edges and highlight the top with a bit of white or something like that, just to simulate that kind of bubbling effect. But yeah, it's very, very useful and I really like it. So I am on Instagram. If you want to check out my Instagram channel, I'm on there posting occasional things from around the studio, little side projects and whatnot, a few Christmas baubles lately. There will be seasonal things on there and such. I also occasionally post things like my little mascot here, who I picked up a while ago, who someone suggested I name Igris, and I like that, Igris. I think that's going to be his name. And also, you know, things like my little custom chapter of Space Marines there for my Warhammer obsession. Yeah, so a few things from around the studio will get posted on Instagram. Feel free to follow me on there. I am also on Patreon if you want to check that out. If you feel like donating a dollar of your hard-earned cash, then that's perfectly fine by me. My patrons, who I am eternally grateful for, already do that, and I'm very, very thankful to you guys. So thanks very much for watching this one. If you did like it, feel free to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, tell your friends, and share the video online or something like that, and I will get back to you soon with another video. That's it for this one though, and I'll see you again next time. Thanks for stopping by, and happy crafting.